So let's do chapter 14 water. So it says, suppose for some reason your family gets only one bucket of water every day for a week. So it is asking you to like imagine of a scarcity of water, only one bucket. We can't do anything for a week. Okay, it will get over very soon. Imagine what would happen. You would be able to cook, clean utensil, wash clothes or bath. What are the other activities you would not be able to do? So not much we can do with one bucket of water. What would happen if we do not have easy access to water for a long period of time? If we don't have water, we cannot do the work as given here in this paragraph. Apart from drinking, there are so many activities for which we use water. Yes, here it is given. Cooking, cleaning, washing, bathing, drinking, many things are there. Do you have an idea about the quantity of water we use in a single day? So it can be measured. How many buckets of water do we use daily? It can be measured. How much water do we use? So one activity is given here. Okay. So it is saying list all the activities for which use water in a day. Some activities are listed in table 14.1. Some of the activities are given here: drinking, brushing, bathing, washing utensils, washing clothes, toilets, cleaning floor, any other. So how much water do we use? Okay. Amount can be measured in liters or in buckets, number of buckets of water we use, or in volume we can use. So this table says that make a similar table in your notebook throughout the day. Measure the amount of water used for each activity by you and other family member. You may use a mug, a glass, a bucket or any other container to measure the amount of water use. So any container you can use to measure the number of that number of containers of water used. You now have a rough idea as to how much water your family uses in a day. So now you have a rough idea how much bucket of water your family is using. Can you estimate the amount of water used by your personal cleanliness in a day? How much you have used personally? You can measure and estimate. Using this information, calculate the amount of water needed by your family in a year. Now, multiply it with 365. If one day is some mugs of water, so how many mugs of water in a year? Or in one day, suppose 5 buckets of water. So in 1 year, how much buckets of water you will use? So 5 into 365. That many buckets of water you will use. That much buckets of water you will use. Now divide this amount by the number of members of your family. So simply dividing will give you how much each member is using. This will give an idea of the amount of water needed by one member of your family in a year. Find the number of people that live in your village or town. Okay, then find the number of people that live in a village of time. So that will give you the calculation of how much water will be used by a village in particular time, or say 1 year. 1 year of time, how much water they will need. So if we know for one person, we can know for 10%, we can know for the number of person living in a village or town. You may now get an idea of the amount of water needed by your village or town in a year. So we can calculate based on the calculations, how much water will be needed by a village or town in 1 year. So Bujo wonders whether people living in different regions of our country get the same amount of water. Are there regions where people do not get adequate amount of water? How do they manage? So one question is there, does everyone get proper amount of water as per their needs? Okay, or they do not get. If they do not get, how do they manage the water problems? Okay. So you have listed a number of activities for which you use water. So you have listed a number of activities for which you use water. In the previous page, we have seen what are the different things where we use water. Do you think our water requirement is limited to activities like this? Okay. We use wheat, rice, pulses, vegetables, and many other food items every day. So we use wheat, rice, pulses, vegetables, and many other food items every day. We know that some of the fibers that we use for making fabric come from plants. Is water not needed to grow this? So apart from the water that we consume daily, we have to provide water for the plants also. Okay, because we need food to eat, so we have to grow the plants. And plants also need water. So water have to be sent for irrigation, for agricultural work also. Okay. Can you think of the more uses of water? There can be even more uses of water. For constructions also. Okay, for industries also it will be used. Okay, so many places water will be used. So now it says water is used in industries for producing almost all the things that we use. So water is needed in industries for producing the things. So we need water not only for our daily activities, but also for producing many things. So not only for our own daily needs, we use water for many other things apart from our daily needs. So pahali want to tell you that about 2 glasses of water are required to produce each page of a book. So the book's pages are prepared from the plant products. Okay. So and it also need water, and 1 page of a book need 2 glasses of water for its production. Okay. It is produced in industries or paper mills. So that need lots of water for paper production. Where do we get water from? Next topic says, from where do we get water? Where do you get the water that you use? Some of you may say we draw water from a river. So some people will say we get water from river, spring, pond, wells, or a hand pump. Okay, these are the sources of water. Some others might say we get water from taps. Okay, so it is very direct that we get water from taps. But actually the tap water comes from the tank. And tank is filled by the water that is supplied from the water departments. Okay. Or from the underground water. We fill our tanks and tanks is filled. So taps get water from the tanks. Have you ever wondered where the water in the taps comes from? Water that we get from taps is also drawn from a lake or a river or a well. So the tap water are also drawn from well, river or a lake. It is then supplied through the network of pipes, and through the network of pipes, it is supplied to the different houses. So this figure shows that water in taps comes from rivers, lakes, bore wells or wells. So here is a connection to a river or lake is shown, and pipe connections are there, network of pipes are shown, from which the water will go to the tank, which is on the top of the house. So from there, the tank water will come to the pipes and to the taps of different floors. Now, each of us may be getting water into our homes in different ways, but finally, all of us get water from the same sources, such as ponds, lakes, rivers, and wells. So the source of water remains same. We have discussed some of the sources of water. Where does the water come from to fill this ponds, lakes, rivers, and wells? Now, from where these sources of water get the water? This is the question. Okay. So the basic thing is the rainfall. From rainfall, these areas get filled, like ponds, lakes, and rivers and wells get filled. So Bujo wants you to imagine a day in your life when water supply through taps is not available. So it will be a very difficult situation. So you have to fetch it yourself from a far away place. Would you use the same amount of water on any other day? So when there is a water problem, there is a scarcity of water, then we have to fill the water from a distance place. Suppose we have to go to the river and fill it from the river in a bucket, or from the well we have to fetch. Okay, so it is difficult to fill the water. So we will try to use minimum amount of water when water is less. Okay. Or when it is difficult to get water, we try to minimize the water usage. Now this figure shows oceans cover a major part of the earth. So it is saying, do you know that about 2/3 of the earth is covered with water? Most of this water is in oceans and seas. The water in the oceans and seas has many salts dissolved in it. The water is saline. We all know ocean water is saline. It is very salty. Okay, it is not fit for drinking. Okay. So it is not fit for drinking and other domestic, agricultural and industrial needs. Because of the salt, it cannot be used in domestic, agricultural and industrial needs also. You might have heard the famous lines of the poem Rhyme of the Ancient Mariner, written by S.T. Coleridge in 1798. Water, water everywhere, nor any drop to drink. Means everywhere it is water, but not a single drop which is fit to drink. So here the poet has described the plight of sailors on a ship lost in the ocean. So this is for the sailors who are lost in ocean and they have plenty of water everywhere, but nothing for drinking. Okay, nothing available. Yet oceans play an important role in supplying the water that we use. Still, oceans play an important role in supplying the water that we use. Do you find this surprising? After all, the water that we use is not salty. Okay, the water that we use is not salty. The salts are removed. Many of us live in places far away from the oceans. Does the water supply in these places also depend on the oceans? How does the ocean water reach ponds, lakes, rivers and well which supply us water? So this is discussing about the places which are far away from the oceans, but still it is saying that oceans play an important role in filling up the ponds, lakes and rivers and wells. So how it happens, how come the water from these sources is not saline anymore? From other sources water is not saline anymore. So that is where the water cycle. Ponds water is not saline, river water is not saline. Okay, only the ocean water is saline, sea water is saline. Okay, the land water is not saline. Okay, the water that comes in the tap is not saline. So how it happens? It happens because of the water cycle. So water cycle, what is it? Disappearing trick of water. Okay, so disappearing trick of water. So water disappears. You have a wet cloth, you keep it in sun, it will dry. So water disappears. Okay, so where it went? It went to the atmosphere. Okay, and when it rises up, it will be added up to the clouds. Okay, it condenses and it will form the clouds. Okay, and then it will be, when it is heavy, it will come down in the form of rain. So that is water cycle, rain or hail. Okay, or it will be in atmosphere also. So disappearing trick of water. How many times have you noticed that water spilled on a floor dries up after some time? Okay, the water seems to disappear. So if water is fallen on the ground, it will disappear after some time. Similarly, water disappears from wet clothes as they dry up. Okay, when you will have a cloth, you put it in sun, it will be dried. Yeah, water from wet roads, rooftops and a few other places also disappears after the rains. Okay, when it rains also from the rooftop, after some time water will disappear. So where does the water go? Do you remember activity 6 in chapter 5, in which water was with salt dissolved in it was heated? So when salt water will be heated, so water will be evaporated and only salt will be left in the container. What did we find? The water evaporated and the salt was left behind. This activity gives us an idea that on heating, water changes into its vapor. So this is exactly what is happening. So when the water is evaporated, it changes into vapor, and water vapor is lighter, so it will rise up. Okay. We also realize from this activity that water vapor does not carry away the salt with it. So the salt is not evaporated because the salt will be left behind and water is evaporated. So water vapor so found become a part of the air. So water vapor that comes out of the boiling water becomes a part of the air. Okay, and mixes up with the air and rises up and cannot usually be seen. It is gas, so it is not usually be seen. We also find that heating is essential to convert water into its vapor. So heating is essential. Because of heat only water is evaporated and it changes to vapor. However, we have seen that water changes into its vapor also from the fields, roads, rooftops and other land areas. From everywhere water gets evaporated and it depends upon the temperature, how fast it evaporates. If the sunlight is more, then it will dry fast, and in a rainy day it may not dry up fast. Okay. We also discussed in chapter 5 that to obtain salt, water from the sea is left in shallow pits to let the water evaporate. So in shallow pits the water are stored and it evaporates and the salt is left behind. From where does this water get the heat it needs to evaporate? Let us find out. Okay, so it get evaporated by the sunlight. Okay, or from the atmospheric temperature it can evaporate. So take two similar plates, place one of the plates in sunlight and keep the other under shade. So it is asking to take two plates, fill it with water and keep in one in sunlight and one in shade. So now it says pour equal amount of water in each of the plates. So both plates will have equal amount of water. So put one plate in the sun and one plate in the shadow. So you can use a cap of a bottle to measure water. For equal water, you can use some measuring device like cap of the water itself you can use to measure it. Make sure that water does not spill over. Observe the two plates after every 15 minutes. So time to time you have to check what is the water left in the plates. Does the water seem to disappear? From which plate does it disappear first? So which plate will dry up first? So naturally it is which is kept in the sun will dry up fast. Okay, it will be the first to be dried. So what is the source of heat for this evaporation? So sunlight. Sunlight is a source of heat for this evaporation. So during daytime, sunlight falls on the water in oceans, rivers, lakes and ponds. The fields and other land areas also receives sunlight. As a result, water from all these places continuously changes into vapor. So the water from all the places are changed into vapors because of the sunlight, the heat because of the sunlight. However, the salt dissolved in the water are left behind, and the minerals and salt that is in water is left behind. Only the water get evaporated. In activity 2, did you find that water also disappeared from the plate kept in the shade? Though it could have taken more time. So which the plate which is kept in shadow also or in the shade also evaporates, but it will take longer time for it to evaporate. So if the sunlight is direct, it will evaporate fast, and if it is shade or indirect sunlight, then it will evaporate slowly. Does the heat from the sun reaches here? Yes. During the daytime, all the air surrounding us gets heated. This warm air produces heat from evaporation of water in the shade. So the atmospheric temperature or the air temperature will cause the water to evaporate slowly, but it will cause the water to evaporate. Does evaporation take place from all open surfaces of water? Yes, and the answer is yes. Yeah, evaporation takes place from all the open surfaces of water. As a result, water vapors get continuously added to the air. So this is how water vapors are continuously added to the air. However, evaporation of water is a slow process. Okay, it is also saying that evaporation is a slow process because the heating is low, the temperature is low. So it takes long time for water to evaporate. So that is why we rarely notice its loss from a bucket full of water. So it is not observed directly with the eyes. It is not easy to see the evaporation happening. Okay. In sunlight, evaporation takes place faster. However, in sunlight, evaporation takes place faster, you know, because of the direct heat of the sun. On heating water on a burner, its evaporation takes place even faster. And we heat water on a burner or in a fire, on fire, we can see it is faster. Evaporation takes place faster. Is there any other process through which water vapor gets transferred into air? Is there any other process? Yes, transpiration that happens from the leaves of plant. This also releases water to the atmosphere. Okay, so now it discusses loss of water by plants. Have you learned in chapter 7 that plants need water to grow? So plants use a part of this water to prepare their food and retain some of it in their different parts. So plants retain water in their different parts. The remaining part of this water is released by the plant into air. So plant releases remaining water into the air as water vapor through the process of transpiration. Through the process of transpiration, water is released to the atmosphere. Do you remember observing transpiration of water by plants in activity 4 in chapter 7? So we have already done it in chapter 7, where we have learned the transpiration process by the plant. It happens from the leaves of the plant. Water vapor enters the air through the process of evaporation and transpiration. So it now says that water vapors enters in the air through the process of evaporation and through the process of transpiration. Is it loss forever? No, it is not a loss. We get it back again, as we will see. So whatever water is released to the atmosphere or air, it is not lost at all. We will again get it back in the, and we will study about it in coming paragraphs. So it happens with the process of water cycle. The evaporation takes place, water condenses and falls back to earth, and we get it back. So how are cloud forms is the next topic. So let us take a glass filled with water. Wipe the glass from the outside with a clean piece of cloth. Add some ice into the water. Wait for 1 or 2 minutes. Observe the changes that take place on the outer surface of the glass. From where do water drops appears on the outer surface of the glass? So if you take a glass, fill it with cold water, we will see water droplets on the outer surface of the glass. So from where it comes, from where this water came. So atmosphere contains water vapors. So when it comes in contact with a cold glass surface, the water condenses and the droplets are seen on the glass surface. So this is how we can see water droplets on the glass. The cold surface of the glass containing iced water cools the air around it, and the water vapor of the air condenses on the surface of the glass. We noticed this process of condensation in activity 7 in chapter 5. We have already done this activity in chapter 5. Okay, so this figure shows this is ice here, this is cold water, and these are water droplets that is seen on the surface of the glass. Drops of water appears on outer surface of the glass containing water with ice. So Pahali has noticed dew on leaves of grass on winter morning. On winter morning, you can see dew on the grass. Did you notice something similar on the leaves or metal surface like iron grill and gates on a cold morning? Is this also due to condensation? Do you see this happening on hot summer morning? In hot summer morning, it is less, but in winter, it can be seen easily. Okay. So the process of condensation plays an important role in bringing water back to the surface of Earth. So how it is brought back to Earth? The water is brought back to Earth. It is because of the process of condensation. How does it happen? As we go higher from the surface of the Earth, it gets cooler. So we know as we go up the altitude, we will get cooler atmosphere, or the atmospheric temperature will be low. And it will be very low on top of a hill or above that. It will be even lower. So when the air moves up, it gets cooler and cooler. At sufficient heights, the air becomes so cool that the water vapor present in it condenses to form tiny drops of water called droplets. So once it becomes cool enough, it will be converted to water droplets. It is these tiny droplets that remain floating in air and appear to us as clouds. So these are those tiny droplets that are joined together and they seem to be floating in the air. And those are actually clouds that we see as clouds. It so happens that many droplets of water come together to form larger sized drops of water. So many droplets join together to form larger drops of water. Some drops of water become so heavy that they begin to fall, and after becoming heavy, they start falling to the ground. These falling water drops are what we call rain. Okay, so this is rain. In a special condition, it may also fall as hail or snow. It can also comes down in the form of hail or snow. Thus, water in the form of vapor goes into air by evaporation and transpiration from clouds, and then comes back to the ground as rain, hail, or snow. So the water that has gone to the atmosphere, after condensation, it becomes water droplets. And water droplets join together to form drops of water, which are joined together. And when it becomes heavy, it starts falling down. And that is called rain. And water can come down to earth in the form of rain. It can also be seen in the form of hail or snow.